Hello there. Today I'm going to talk about Italian culture and my reading of Italian culture based on someone who was born in Italy and lives abroad and now travels back on holiday and those good things. Obviously, I've got family there, friends there and whatever. So there's in no particular order. Rules of the road. Massive generalisation. The standard of driving deteriorates as you head south. People will park a lot closer to you than you might be used to. And in the south, and I'm thinking Sicily here, people will leave insanely small spaces between their car and your car. And if you haven't, I've seen people nudge car backwards and forwards to get in and out of a space. No, seriously. Crossing the road. Crossing the road can be quite a challenge at times. In my experience, particularly in Naples, my advice is cross at the crossings, make eye contact with the driver, and make sure you do stay within the crossing because there is a legal difference in the case of an incident if you're hit on a crossing or just jaywalking. You may find the drivers do slow down, but they will slow down at the last minute. And if you really are not convinced, follow a local. That's the safest way because they will stop for them. Motorcycle helmets called casco. This is a long and complex story which goes back of many decades. It is more regularly adopted now, but you will still see it in the summer where people will wear their motorcycle crash helmet in their elbow and put it on if the police turn up. And in fairness, in the summer, there is some, I can understand why they do this in the summer because it can be hot. But one thing to look out for there. Local interpretations as to what a red light is. Well, that's quite an interesting one. This is, I've had experience of being hooted for stopping at a red light. So, and again, I'm going to give credit to Naples there, which is not the only one, but it's really quite an extraordinary approach to what a red light is. Moving over to Sicily a little bit, but not only Sicily. If you're thinking about hiring a car, bear in mind a lot of narrow streets are hard to navigate if you've got a large SUV. I'm thinking of Ortigia, but I'm not thinking only of Ortigia, so bear that in mind as well. Drinking in public. It is normal to drink in public across Europe, and you will find there are cafes and bars that serve alcohol in public, and you will have children running around there as well. Unlike in America, you don't always have to show ID. You certainly don't have to show ID to be 25, but you will be asked to leave if you're deemed to appear drunk. In America, there's this concept of having a paper bag to carry alcohol in the street. You won't see that. It is common for people to have a picnic in the park, the beach, drink alcohol, and we're talking limited quantities to be fair. Unless there's a sporting event. This is particularly popular in scenic areas where, for example, people might go to the coast to watch a sunset. I have to say, from a cultural perspective, in Italy, it's deemed very embarrassing to be seen drunk in public. Okay, everyone's favourite. Queuing in Italy is a very complicated topic. The Italian view to queuing tends to be try to get to the front by any means necessary. It is true. This may be very different from what you're used to. And I can give you an example where quite recently, actually, I was sitting in a local government office in Sicily and we're in the middle of a meeting and someone opened the door on our meeting. He was the next person in the queue and he did not feel it right that he was having to wait when I was in the middle of a meeting. So that can happen. If you're paying in a coffee shop, bear in mind, sometimes you need to manoeuvre your way to pay at the cash desk before you buy your coffee. And sometimes you need to do this before you even get served and then hand over the receipt to the bar staff. And don't be shy, you sometimes do have to use your elbows to do it. Saying that in terms of queuing, the tourist attractions are extremely popular and particularly in peak season, you are advised to book well in advance. That's where queuing really does work. Units of measure. bear in mind in Europe there's a metric system. Do not expect Italians to know how to convert the metric system. It's your job to have an app on your smartphone if you need it. Paying. In a lot of shops, you need to pay at the cash desk, get a receipt, and then go and get served. That's the way it is. I know it's not the most efficient way of doing it, but that's the way it is. If you're consuming, for example, in a cafe, a coffee at La Banchina, which is in store by the counter, you will pay one price. If you are sitting outside getting table service, sitting down consuming sometimes to a band or whatever it is, particularly in a tourist area, you will pay another price. So bear that in mind. Try to avoid being ripped off by buying any hawker stands near tourist attractions. Any of them at all. Do not buy anything from them. You are being ripped off. They know it too. That's why they're there. You are warned. There's also the concept of bella and brutta figura, which is making a good and a bad impression. So in Italy, there's lots of expected ways of behaving, and it's too complicated to go into a video here now, but there are quite well-known norms of behavior, one of which is not to be seen drunk in public, but there are a whole bunch of others as well, and this is about making good and bad impression. And so just bear this in mind, because when the Italians tend to be used to seeing tourists behaving in what's perceived to be brutta figura, which is making a bad impression. Try to be one of the good guys and don't let down the people from your country. Italians have a very specific view on how to dress. They do not put clothes on. They dress in an outfit. And this may be slightly different from what you may be used to. And there are scenarios where they will perhaps appear to overdress for some events. You will get used to this, but notice there is a difference. This is an opportunity for you to live like the Italians and do as they do. An Italian lady will tell you they do not put on clothes, they get dressed in a coordinated outfit. A good example to dress up is la passeggiata, which happens in the early evening in the summer, where the Italians will go out for a stroll to see and to be seen. If you come from a cold climate, you may find Italians wear winter clothes on what you think is a warm day. The summer. Italian summers are swelteringly hot, and as time goes by, they are getting hotter. Particularly in August, the city's empty as people travel to go on holiday at the coast. There's a reason for doing it. So if you are traveling in Italy and staying in Italy in the summer, make sure you have aircon in your room. That's not always the case in Europe, as it is in, perhaps in America. So you are warned. The holiday season is bookended by massive traffic jams as well in Italy, as people respond to Ferragosto, timekeeping. Italians tend to arrange their lives on the go using smartphones and WhatsApp. This means punctuality and timekeeping habits can vary a little bit from what you may be used to. I'm not going to name and shame other countries and whatever, but if you're used to timekeeping by the dot on dot, Italy has a slightly more subjective interpretation of what that means. Do not assume that shops and banks are open when you think they will be. There's a good chance they will open at different times from what you're used to. The time to get your errands and shopping done is in the morning or sometimes in the early evening, but if it's banks, definitely the morning, as they will often close in the afternoon. They also may be closed one day midweek as well. This is one of the first things you should do when you arrive, is find out the shop opening and closing times. Eating out in the evening tends to be late. I don't know what you're used to, but this can be 8, 9, 10 in the evening. That's quite common, that is. Join me for part 2. Well, thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like this video and subscribe so that others can see it. Click here for some more videos you may be interested in.